we're going to learn intro physics mechanics, that is Newtonian mechanics. The way we're going to do it is different than is traditionally done for three different reasons. One, we're going to introduce all the basic concepts simultaneously on the first day and build in complexity throughout the quarter. Two, we're going to flip the classroom where students will watch lecture videos at home and work in groups during class time. And three, we're going to use free online resources. In traditional physics classes, each concept is covered very thoroughly before moving on to the next concept. Instead, we're going to introduce all four basic concepts of physics together on the first day and build in complexity over the quarter. We will add the math and vectors and units as they become necessary. And then we'll do the same thing again for rotational motion, thereby again reviewing the concepts. And we're going to learn physics kind of like we learn our first language. We just start talking it. We just start doing it. The reason we do that is because although it's very nice to think we've learned everything about a basic concept and then build on it, people don't really learn that way. Studies show that people learn best through iteration, just like we learned our first language. The most important step in understanding a physics problem is identifying the underlying concepts. But in traditional classes, we don't learn this well because by focusing on one concept at a time, you know that that's going to be the concept that you use for every homework problem that week. If we're studying the energy chapter, all the homework problems deal with energy. We know that. The formulas are probably on the last page of that chapter. And so what we learn is how to plug numbers into a formula. We go to that formula page, we get the formula, we put the numbers in. Or then on the final exam, or for challenges later on in other classes, we haven't practiced identifying concepts and talking about concepts. So by dealing with all the concepts simultaneously, we get much better at differentiating the different concepts and identifying where each might be the most helpful. After 4 years and 11 classes, I can tell you most students prefer learning this way. And the overwhelming majority of students agree that this method results in them thinking more about underlying concepts. Flipping the classroom. In most physics classes, the instructor lectures during class, and the students go home and work on homework problems, usually alone. If we switch this around, I think it improves the process for two reasons. One, when you're at home watching a lecture video, you can stop me if I go too fast. You can also rewind. You can talk to people. Ideally, you'll be watching it with your friends, and you can stop and talk about something that you might understand. You can actually write notes down if you all agree there's a problem and you can bring it into class. That would be great. So I think watching lecture videos at home is a better way to be introduced to the material. But the real reason this is great is because it leaves the classroom open for activities, and that's where the real learning occurs. Because it's through the dialogue, through the discussions, arguments, picture drawing that we learn physics. Additionally, studies show that students learn better from each other than they do from a designated expert. Not only does the student receiving help benefit, but the student helping also benefits greatly in what we call peer instruction. Resources. Because this is a very different way of learning physics, I've written a short, concise text. It's about a tenth the number of words you get in a regular textbook, so it's small. And I can give it to you chapter by chapter, about 4 pages each. I think students like this. Because one, it's short enough that they actually read it. Two, it's small enough so they carry it around with them. They write all over it. They draw pictures on it. It's actually a very valuable resource for them. But that's not the only resource, because you also have access to all my past classes with homeworks, with tests, with solutions. Between this text and all the material you have access to and the videos, you have very comprehensive resources to learn physics. The website that you find right up here will provide access to all the videos, the text, and the resources from past classes. Your responsibility is to see the videos before coming to class so you're ready to learn with your peers and to develop a supporting network of friends to solve problems with. I think this is a better way to learn physics. And besides that, by learning how to rely on each other and work in groups, you may be developing the most important skill you'll gain in college. I've done this for 11 classes now, and every quarter I enjoy it, and I learn more from my students. And I'm looking forward to this quarter with you guys.